Maybe the second match from day two of action here in Pool 4, Belgrade, Serbia. Turkey in white having had that serve against the Netherlands in blue, looking for side out, and they're not going to get it. It's an unforced error, and the first point goes the way of Turkey. Was made to serve again. Chase is on. Ooh, you have to be careful. Maladin nearly caused herself a mischief then. Used to be when playing that the advertising hoarding was made out of cardboard. You could run straight through it. Not anymore. Wide. Jesper though into a very big Turkish block. Swing. Indy Bayens, the opposite player, coming up with the goods to level things up. Trouble again for Turkey here. Oh, nice block from Karakut. And the first thing that the Netherlands do is go to the referee and say, it was still on our side, we could have played it. And the referee saying no, it had gone over the net and Karakut was well within her rights to block it. Timmerman. Very positive start this for the Netherlands. Trying to force that ball to the middle, and it was obvious where she was going. The Netherlands able to get a big block out to stop it. Another steady swing from the Netherlands. They increase their lead to three. That time Karakut late to get to the block. Well played. Just went a little early, ball a little too high, couldn't have a full swing, but was able to reach up and tip it over the top of the block. She couldn't get there in time. Netherlands get their side out. ball behind. There's a positive set, the ball continuing on its journey from passer to setter and then out to the attack. So the ball has pace on it. A negative set is where the setter then goes the opposite way, as we've just seen there, breaking the lines. In other words, taking the energy from the ball, then putting it back into the ball to send it out in another direction. That was one that continued on the line. The previous one, as seen from the ref cam. Good up. Well, that's a great pickup. Free ball for Turkey. Ojbey in waiting. Three front court attackers. Four people moving. Oh, that's lovely. Just brilliant volleyball. Ackman delivering the final blow. There was not much that the Netherlands could do. They kept it on the floor, off the floor in the first instance. Scrambling it back over, hoisted high to try and allow the Netherlands to reset their block defense. Turkey took full advantage. It was a great ball in from Jesper for Udi Lukitus to be able to put the ball on the floor into the first technical timeout. Netherlands leading by two.
Outside antenna, you have to walk on antenna. Nothing different. If you jump 1 meter inside antenna, then you will come 1 meter inside antenna. We don't give point if she have no possibility of other direction. And we have to start to defense, eh? Okay, the tip on one leg, they don't have to fall down. The tip in the middle of the court in one leg, don't have to fall down, and we have to attack.
See the different ways to win a point. As long as the ball hits the floor or goes off the block and out, you get a point. Oh, good block. Ackman with nowhere to go. Block from Nicole. Too high, too far for Turkey. A few issues in this first set. Dikma with the serve. Free ball for the Netherlands. That's a great pickup. Another chance for the Dutchies here. But there was nowhere for Lois to go, and Turkey make the block, they get the point. And don't let the Netherlands get too far away. The Netherlands had plenty of chances to win that rally. Lovely. That's the value of a good ball in. That opens up all your hitting options. Massive time pressure on Turkey. In other words, not enough time to make a decision as to where to go and help out in the block. And the Netherlands able to put the ball away through the middle. Baladin just let that ball hit her. As a result, free ball Netherlands. Three more attacking options. Oh, that's a cracking block. One on one, you'd have expected the Netherlands to put the ball on the floor, but Melissa Isameoglu made sure that didn't happen. Osbay with the serve. That's close. Osbay now has to organise her offence. She's talking to her three front court hitters as to giving them the signals as to what she or what they're going to get. By Baines. Jasper with nowhere to go. Turkey's block is keeping them in this first set. Miss Mayoglu. Covering behind Jasper. Good up from Osbay. Karakurt with work to do. But she's unable to put the ball on the floor, and it's the Netherlands who come up with a decent block. By Turkey. Banadin decided it was going long. Right choice for her. Hitting the back row attack. If you watch this, she just comes inside the slide attack. A variation, that particular last player, variation on what you normally see where the attacker on the back row hits from the extreme right side. Good up from Osbay. Karakurt gets the point for Turkey. Really nice pickup by the setter for Turkey. And a solid swing from Karakurt. Well, it was a good serve from Karakurt. And then a great block from Ackman. You can see that Karakurt's got some work to do still with her physique to be able to deliver a little bit more power in the ball. Just collapses slightly with her core at the moment. And she gets it right though. That was a very good serve again. And Netherlands struggling a little here to get their side out. Free ball for Turkey. Well, they were calling for touches and in, and it looks like it's going to be neither. Well, so anyway, it does look like it's in. Looked well in, didn't it? From then, considering we just saw the ref's view then, that was his view from his camera. Deciding not to overrule the Lions judge who said it was out, so we're having a challenge because Turkey think it was in. Indeed it was. Oh, classic Diekmann. Everybody expecting that ball to be set out wide. Nobody expecting that. This will stay in play. Turkey still knocking on the door for a point, and they get it. Turkey beginning to find some cohesion and rhythm about their play, despite Guidetti shaking his head. Baladin with the serve. Luis gets that side out, and that means the Netherlands go into the second technical timeout, leading by two.
Oh, it's Telenoli, but for everyone in zone four, just remember, small blocker out there. Make sure we're attacking that person, not the big middle blockers. Make sure we're going after that. I heard her call Snell on a ball from off the net. Make sure we're setting what they call, or call Hogue maybe in that situation. I like the swings we're taking. Again, just avoid the middles. Make sure we're in there. Keep serving space around seven or nine. They're both passing okay. Keep it flat. Keep it on them. Let's go.
Simple and to the point from Jamie Morrison. That was a really nice play. A different variation on the back row attack. And then that ball a little bit too low for Lois. Well, look at that. There was a net touch, wasn't there? No one saw it. Tikma then back to serve. Netherlands just about holding on to their lead. Swing from Ackman. Netherlands not finishing their block in time. That's been given as an ace. Brilliant serving. Both teams are working the blocks well. Jamie Morrison had said to his team to stay away from the middle blocker, go after the shorter outside blockers, and also in serving, he's asking them to put the ball between Baladin and Yildirim. And also, as we just saw them, trying to make it difficult for Baladin and Izmioglu to work together. That's a great block from Bayens. It's the speed of the attack that gave Turkey the point. Too quick for the Netherlands block to react, more the defenders behind the block. Ushbe. Classic. Middle blockers, and any blockers for that matter, have gone up to try and make a block on the ball, but haven't seen the impact of the ball into their hands, have closed their eyes or have looked at their feet. And then as that ball's come off the block, Gunesh is looking around to say, where's it gone? And it's landed right by her feet. They've taken off the net. Izmioglu now with the serve. Putting the Netherlands under pressure, making it difficult for them to run the middle. Turkey getting good touches in transition. And a nice swing as well from Izmioglu on the pipe. And Turkey back level. Oh, good serve. That was right on to Hesper Jesper. Netherlands now calling the timeout as they suddenly find themselves behind in this set.
One, make sure we're talking. That ball might be out. It's coming in a hurry. Be ready to open up on these balls. They also serve short after getting an ace the last time. So make sure, not this server, but just be careful of that. We talked about it. Just so happens, 19-20. Now it's about being us. I want to see a little bit more fire from here on out, too. Go get them. Let's go.
Jamie Morrison saying about the last time they got an ace, they went short. That's real-time statistical information being passed to him via the little earpiece he's got. There are scouts sat around the court who are watching video. They're making notes. They're looking at exactly where the opposition is serving. Not only that, they're looking at where they're serving on particular rotations. And also what they're looking at is the where Turkey then attacking the ball once they've made their passing, and all of that information is then brought together to help them to either confirm the game plan they have or make adjustments to it where they need to try and win the set and ultimately win the match. That looked like a miss hit from Karakurt. It caught the Netherlands by surprise. No, it wasn't a miss hit, it was a very well played and very well disguised roll shot. Once again, Netherlands unable to run their middle, so Turkey able to put a couple of blockers up. But that is a wonderful swing, high and into the corner from Marit Jesper. Head coach Giovanni Guidetti has already said to his team that if the hitter's a metre inside the antenna, be a metre inside the antenna blocking. That last play, when Jesper scored the point, Turkey's block had gone too wide. Netherlands making changes. Annick Sebring coming in. It's a serving substitution. Bands going off for the moment. Well, it was a... In fact, it's not a serving substitution, it's a direct replacement, opposite for opposite. But Bayern's obviously not doing what Jamie Morrison wants her to. Not often you see that, opposite substitution in that situation. And a net touch against the Netherlands. Well, that's a wasted opportunity. Turkey now 2 points away from taking the set. Desperately not to touch the net. Paladin was looking for hands, didn't find them. Or did she? Challenge has been called. It looked like it was going... went miles out. The question is, did it catch any fingers on its way out? Didn't look like it. But if anything, Turkey have got themselves a timeout here because they've delayed the play. Any momentum that they were looking for, Netherlands that is, they're not going to get. That is clearly out. Didn't touch anybody. But a serve. Gift for Turkey, which brings up set point. Double substitution for Turkey. Setter goes into the back row. The captain Bosch comes into the front row in the opposite, and it's number 11, Ezgi Dilik, on to serve and then to set. It's a feature of Turkey's play. They did it in their opening game with a double substitution, and they're doing it again here. Good dig. Baladin is not going to find a way through. Solid blocking by the Netherlands to save the first set point. Good high hands defense that from Sarioglu. Turkey have called the timeout.
They have the setter and they have middle blocker of 2 meters. And we play all transition there. The bomber can be little more bomber. Okay? But then we go playing that. Then we go playing that. Right. 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 What do you want to play? Come on. Aide.
Aide.
Big out.
Let's go.
Very different coaching styles. Jamie Morrison never once talking about individuals or things that you've done. Just looking at what he likes, what they're doing well, things that they need to be working on and confirming things. Whereas Guidetti quite clearly saying to Ballardin, don't go into the middle blocker. Go and do this. Go and do something else. So almost a little bit of a telling off from Guidetti to Ballardin. But it's after the fact, isn't it? So more changes. Meyers has come in for the Netherlands. A little bit of blocking height at the net as they try to stay in this set. Timmerman with the serve. Not going to happen. Ekman puts the ball down on the C quick. The short behind. Turkey take the first set, 25-22. Wasn't a bad serve, decent ball in. Options for Turkey. You could see the three players too wide, keeping the blockers wide, so only a one-on-one in the middle. And Ekman with no trouble putting that down. Massive pressure, in fact, on number 17. Then you could see that. Lutikwisi had two players bearing down on her. Well, it was a decent start for the Netherlands, but it's Turkey who turned it around to take the set. Just looking back at the highlights from that last set, you can see that when Diekma goes to set behind, she's pretty much her hands and her body position is already saying, I'm going to be setting behind. Whereas for Dilic, she pretty much is vertical and then sets with her, using her shoulders and her wrists. This is the stats from the first set. And it was one in which Turkey just managed to turn things around in their favour come the end. Here are the spike contact points for Turkey from the right side, the middle, and the left side. So most of the ball's going out to four to the outside hitters. And for the Netherlands, similar sort of thing. But hardly used the middle at all, did they, the Netherlands? Two balls that you could call a middle attack. Well, that's the weight of serving for Turkey. That's really what it's all about. If you can disrupt the other team, you can take them out of system, reduce their hitting options. It means that you can get more blockers out into the area where the ball is going to be spiked from. And Turkey managed to do that as the set progressed. Set two is about to get underway. Wojbe back onto court with Karakurt. And we can expect to see the double substitution again at some point in the second set, where Dilic and Boj will come in. generally it will, we can expect to see that when Ujbay will be going into the front row. Second set is started. The Netherlands with the serve. Turkey leading by 1-0. It's been a close fought first set. That ball, not the best ball to Baladin. That's a good dig. Turkey have a better chance now. Better ball to Baladin. Well, Ujbay kind of backing off a little bit. She must have just been below the height of the net as she played that back over. She's a back row player and not allowed to put up a block. As it is, Netherlands take the first point. Recovery by Karakurt. Not sure where Baladin was trying to put that, sending Karakurt right into the middle of the court instead of just digging it in front of her. Nice and high for Karakurt to take on the block. That would have been the spin on the ball, perhaps, because well, she tried to play it just behind her and ended up playing it far too far into court. Touch from Ujbay. Whose side was that on? It was on the Netherlands side. They were entitled to block it. And they've gone up 3-0. Turkey started slowly in the first set. And they've yet to get going in the second. Nice dig by Diekma. Big swing, Karakurt into the corner. What a block that is. A monster block from Baladin. Helped out by Gunesh. Diekma goes behind. You can tell that when she's going behind, it's come right back from Behringer's spike into her face. Just looking at how Laura Diekma goes to set that ball behind. She pretty much sets it off of one leg. Her left leg comes up in the air. She leans back to make the set. There are signs that she's going behind that can give blockers that little bit of an edge potentially if they're looking for the right thing. That ball's gone against the Netherlands. Well, he's convinced she didn't touch the net. There is one element of your body weight you can touch the net with, and it isn't a net touch, and it's pretty much evident in women's volleyball. It certainly wasn't Lois who touched the net, was it? It was Gunesh. That is, if your hair touches the net, it is not a net fault, but anything else it is. Good serving. It's worth noting, whilst your hair doesn't count for a net touch, if the ball should touch your hair when you are blocking as it goes out, then it would be a touch. Sometimes see that happen when the players have jumped and the ponytail's still up in the air above the head and the ball hits it, goes out, and it is a touch against that player. Too tough that one for Diekma. She's back row, she's in the back court. She's not allowed to go up and block the ball or spike the ball because she's a back row player. She knew it was going towards the net and just had to leave it. Tried to make out like she was going to play it. Didn't fall, Balladin. A little bit of confusion for the Netherlands, and Turkey have struck back. Decent touch that from Timmerman, but just took it away from Jasper. Gunesh will serve again, all square in the second set. Once again, Diekma setting behind. Left knee comes up in the air, body arches back. However, Netherlands get the side out. Balladin waiting for that one. Turkey getting a decent block and the square once again. Karakut getting ready for her jump serve. Whoa, they think it was in. Referee says out. They're going to challenge this. Karakut's convinced it was in. One of the best things about the Hawkeye system, a little bit like in tennis, is that because it's an animation, no one ever argues with it. Yet so in the past, when the video representation has been shown by the actual video, and that's clearly in, it was a very good serve, but you would be surprised the number of times when it's close and you see a video representation that players still argue with what they're seeing. But you can't argue with the animation, that one clearly in. And it's real-time tracking of the ball as well, which means that it's 100% accurate. Nice swing. Ackman puts the ball on the floor. And we head into the technical timeout. Turkey in the ascendancy in this second set.
High ball, we don't want nothing in the middle. Why they attack in the middle? Because Debra, last moment, she opened the air to the linea, and Zera cannot find you. On the linea, you are straight. Straight, not left. There is block out, not right. For this, you are straight.
This has been some of the best moments for Ebru Karakut. 19 years of age, actually plays for Vakifbank Istanbul, coached by Giovanni Guidetti, who's the national team coach here, so no surprise to him just how good Karakut is, and the reason why she's in the national team, and in fact the reason why she's a starter. 8 points for her so far, one ace serve, seven attacks, and as yet no blocks. Expect to see that change before the end of this game. Defense. Turkey's block holding fast for the moment, and it's an unforced error. The Netherlands coming in and celebrating, just trying to fool the referee, but not fooling anybody. That's a missed hit down the line. Just having a look at, just trying to turn it, trying to get a bit of the block, but not getting Uzbek. Karakut serves again. Oh, ace serve for Karakut. That's two for her now. Lutaquist with no chance. She's just let the ball hit her. It's a call a photo opportunity. She's stock still, the ball's hit her. You've got to put some momentum into the ball or try and cushion the ball in some way on the hard hit. That's slightly better. That's a top dig. Oh, goodness me. Balladin, number seven, expecting someone else to get the ball so she could have a swing. She was thinking a point or a play ahead instead of being in the now and actually going to play that. That's her ball. She's backed away from it. She should be going towards it. You can't have a swing unless someone's dug the ball or set it to you. So important playing volleyball. It's not like a game of snooker when you've got the table and it's your shot and then you can think two, three, four, five plays ahead. In volleyball, you have to play what's called in the now, which is each touch at a time. That's a very nice swing off the block by Balladin. Oh, sorry, not sorry. That's three aces Turkey have had from serving now. One clean, one off the net, one off a player. It's a cruel blow. No one can get to it. That's one of the consequences as well of modern volleyball and the libero in those situations, because the libero is a defensive specialist. So when this happens, everyone's expecting the libero to go get it. And actually, it's Karakurt's to get. Just like Balladin didn't get the last one, Karakurt's thinking maybe she has to have a hit. But no, she's got to go and dig the ball. Just a little bit too high for Jesper. It's off the block. Jesper a little bit too far into court for that situation. Normally, you want your sixth player deep around about the baseline. For exactly this reason, to get the ball that comes off the block. She's a little bit too high up and then can't get the touch she needs. Block did a really good job of slowing the ball down. Oh, that's unlucky. Ackman's made the dig, but it was coming around the knees of the blockers as they turned around to try and pick it up. It scoops past them. Lovely. Ojbe jumped early, used her hang time, and then really pinged that ball to the middle on a shoot quick. That put huge time pressure on the Netherlands block. They had no chance of getting to that. Ojbe now back to the serving line. And a strong rotation for Turkey. Karakurt into the front row. So height at the net and three attacking options if they can get it into transition. They don't need to. Unforced error from Bayens. And it's getting better and better for Turkey in this second set. Well, it's a little bit lucky for Turkey. But again, it's all the pressure around the block. Three players were in the front row, making it difficult. The ball on the pipe gives Turkey the point. And into the second technical timeout, they lead by seven and by one set to nothing.
Hey, we got to have that dig. It's right at us. We got to have those. Those are one of the ones that we have to have every single time. Service pressure on seven from now on. I want one target, put some pressure on her. And again, it's on our side. Make sure we're taking care of the ball and service seed. We're blowing up like crazy. Be strong. Make the ball go off of us. We direct where it goes. We're better than this. Let's go.
And nobody can help Jansu. It's difficult for him to come to five and set. Or what Ande did, Eileen and Debrag, don't even watch. She cannot come from the net to 9 meters. Then you have to have
Aiden!
Aiden!
Here you go.
Well, these are the issues where the dig has been made and then the player not going. In fact, this is the one point that Guidetti was just talking about, telling Ismailoglu off and saying that there's no way the blockers can get that ball. It had to have been hers as she was in the perfect position, but she was too busy turning her head and not her body to play the ball and didn't link into the play. here we go again. Last third of this second set. We've had the race to 8, the race to 16. And now it's the race to 25. We've had the two dress rehearsals. Kara Kurt saying she didn't touch the ball. Just too many unforced errors from the Netherlands. They were much better than that in the first set. They actually were getting the ball into court, getting it off the block and away, and making it really difficult for Turkey. But the unforced errors have crept in and caused problems for the Netherlands in this second set. Oosbeek getting that one in the face. He's not happy. He's not happy with her block. Have a look at where Kara Kurt was. Very narrow. Didn't take the line away at all. And that was what was being shown. And Oosbeek pays the price. Well, that's an interesting one. It's a touch day serve, but Jamie Morrison had told his team specifically to go after Handy Baladin, number 7, not after the libero, Sarioglu. Or go in the net, for that matter. I just wonder how much information is taken on board in situations like that when the coach gives you more than two bits of information. In that last technical timeout, Jamie Morrison gave, I think it was about 4 bits of information. And it has been said that actually the most a player can take in terms of information is probably 2, 3 maybe. So it's all about getting the salient point across. And if you can reduce it to 1, even better. That one is again another error. Bayern's not finding the block. But they are going to challenge it. Bayern certainly didn't look convinced she'd got the block. Got it off the hands, but we'll know for sure any second now. No, there is a shadow going over the fingers. There is no movement of the fingers. And the shadow is as the ball passes over the top. Unsuccessful challenge, and so the Netherlands call a timeout.
Receivers, we're breaking down again. Strong angle here, make sure we get in the middle of the court. And run our offense. Let's get a good set, take a hard swing right here. Let's go!
Re-emphasizing the serving needs to be tougher and passing needs to be better. Nothing needs to be said for Turkey. They didn't call the timeout. It's going great for them. They're up by 8. Game plan's working. Just take a breather, get some fluid on board, and get ready to go again. And here's Meoglu with the serve. Trouble for the Netherlands. Oosbeek, brilliant chase from her. And then Baladin has been blocked. It was tight to the net. She was tight to the net. And she's actually looked like she's trying to get a bit of a block out, but it is excellent blocking from the Netherlands. Good ball in, and the commit block works for the Netherlands. Baladin makes a good pickup. Netherlands can come again. Oh, good dig. Oh dear, that's a shame. I don't think that helped Oosbeek's cause when she yiked as she went to set that one and then knew it was a double touch. the referee make his decision as well. Great work from Kara Kurt, really making a name for herself on the world stage with her performances so far in this VNL. Brilliant from Kara Kurt, knew that that was an option. Nothing wrong with volleying the ball back over. She almost won the point with it. And it's Baladin who does win the point in the end. The Netherlands just couldn't get full control of the ball in that rally. A great presence of mind as well from Kara Kurt, just 19 years of age and sensing the opportunity, not panicking, to volley it back. Netherlands couldn't build an attack, and then Baladin gets the block, the ball off the block. And down into court. Hester Jesper into the action. Gunesh with her second serve. Good swing from Baladin. Not sure whether, if Ackman knew that Tikmu was back row, which is why she didn't swing on it. Despite the big lead Turkey have got, Giovanni Guidetti has not been a happy chappy at all in this match. Constantly walking around, shaking his head. I've yet to see him smile. Very nice. Running a quick attack in transition. You know that you're in control. Ismailoglu puts a good ball in. Oshbey straight to Ackman. And no chance at all for the Netherlands. What a difference a good pass makes. Suddenly options available for the Netherlands. Suddenly pressure on Turkey's block. Trouble for Netherlands is those good passes have been few and far between in this second set. And then when they have managed to get points, they've not been able to back it up from the serving line. Way too many missed serves. Set point now then for Turkey. Bosch coming in, double substitution. Massive block from Baladin, and Turkey take the second set, 25-14. They lead the Netherlands by 2-0. Good serve from Dilik, great block from Baladin. Hands up and across the net, taking away the space. See, look at, you can see the hands are going across as they went up. Brilliant, brilliant blocking. the stats from that last set. Turkey with three blocks, four aces. Netherlands got a couple, but look at that. 11 errors from the Netherlands, gifting Turkey points. And Turkey credits them only three errors. This is where Turkey have been putting the ball in terms of serve. It's a pretty common statistic to serve on that left-hand side to where the front court passer is to make them try and overload them with work. And for the Netherlands, well, it's been a little bit erratic. It's all down the middle, despite the fact they were told to go after number seven, Balladin. But when you're going after a play, you're not serving right at them, you want to serve in between them. So if you have three passers, and then there are there's two gaps in the court, then two gaps to the sidelines. There's four areas you can serve into. You're kind of aiming at the shoulder of the shoulder height of the passers to get the ball to land near the baseline and put as much pressure on them as you can. Away we go with the third set. Turkey leading 2-0 over the Netherlands. Özbey with the serve. It's a must-win set scenario for the Netherlands. Sensible from Karakurt, putting it back into play. Twice now, Diekma's done that. The ball has hit the floor. And for the second time, Diekma can celebrate. That was brilliant. Just could see Ismailoglu had already gone out to block wide. Expecting something instead of watching to see what was happening. Slow reactions from the Netherlands. A good pickup from Jasper. Timmerman turning. Just couldn't get there quickly enough. Another cruel blow for the Netherlands as that ball comes off the net. It's something you can't legislate for. Teams don't practice it. They're just practicing to serve hard and flat. Oh, goodness me. Well, Özbey just got smacked by Karakurt and couldn't get by her. And that effort was all in vain from Sarıoğlu. Just have a look. Karakurt goes and then back straight into Özbey, not linked into what's going on. Top dig. Karakurt making sure it didn't come back over. Well, you'd have to argue the contact was on the side of Turkey, so it's okay to play it. Dig from Diekma. That'll be a double. Timmerman getting in Mayer's way. Good dig from Balladin. Scoot is allowed to set the ball. So long as she is behind the 3 metre line, you can see she goes off of 1 foot behind the 3 metre line and steps into the 3 metre area after she's let go of the ball. Perfectly legal. Oh, good serve. Ismailoglu. As if someone had said to her, freeze. She's not moving at all as this ball hits her. Collapsing as well, off balance. So two being signalled. That could be to suggest they're going to be blocking cross court. A bit like beach volleyball at times, but it's all very well showing that. You need to get recognition that it's been seen, so the defensive unit behind need to acknowledge that. Karakurt, big jump serve to come. It's a brilliant jump serve. It's the next best thing from an ace because it got the overpass that got them the opportunity to have the swing. Unfortunately, though, Karakurt made a bit of a mess of that one. Levels of serving is the ace, touched ace, the overpass has hit straight back down, and then the overpass that allows you to put the ball into transition and run your options. Good pickup. That's a bit tight, but well watched. Balladin didn't try and go first on that one. She just waited and then pressed last. Bay helped that one away from Karakurt. Just jumped a little bit too early. Ushbay took the ball on the way down. Maya now with the serve. Ismailoglu doesn't find any hands, and the Netherlands have gone in front. Just having a word with the team, on-court captain, just looking to settle things down a little bit. Nice blocking from Lohis. Technical timeout is upon us. Netherlands leading by two, but it's Turkey who are leading by 2-0.
We make one good serve, nobody on the net is ready for 4 years. We're giving 8 points already, 3 A's. Number 21 don't attack, and we're still there, and we don't attack, and we don't attack, and we don't attack.
There's no arguing at all. Giovanni Guidetti is a world-class coach, but that is not world-class coaching. That is really unlucky for the Netherlands. This is some of the super slow-mo action. Great blocking that from Karakurt. You do have to wonder though, don't you, that if you have a coach, you have a timeout and the coach, all the coach has just told you is everything you've just done wrong. We didn't block, we don't attack, we're not attack, we don't. How is that gonna be or in any way helpful to you as a team to go out and try and turn things around? All you've just been told is everything you've just done wrong. Instead of being told, okay, we need to do this, this and this, we need to be working on that, let's try and work, make this happen over here and start being positive. Okay, the players all know they've just made those mistakes. They know what's happened. They've been there and playing in it. That's a wonderful block from the Netherlands. And again, these are the things that can happen off of the back of having a timeout where all you've been done is criticised and told off. And those things can play on your mind a little bit, and then makes it even more tricky when you get back out onto court. Sigh of relief for Turkey as they're given that point. Oh, that's a good touch. Another horrible serve that Turkey putting pressure on the Netherlands with. That's a nice swing. Annick Myers was very close to the 3 metre line, but she didn't touch it with her foot. Great reactions to keep that ball in play off of the serve once it hit the net. Swing as witnessed by the ref cam. 81.9 kilometres an hour that last spike. Smelka can't believe that one's gone out. Ersan has come in. Smelka's gone off. Just so much negativity around the last timeout for Turkey, and as a result of that, they've just gone on and lost a whole bunch of points off the back of it. That's a good block. Gunesh working with Uzbek. It in play. That is Uzbek who got the touch, hence the celebration. Scoot under a bit of pressure. Excellent blocking. Ball slowed down. Turkey into transition. Free ball again for Turkey. Oh, that's really well played. Uzbek's come in. She probably could have set it, but let it go, and then it was all crowded and congested around that 3 metre line. And unfortunately, Sarıoğlu was late to react. Put off a little bit by Gunesh. By Karakurt. Turkey with a good chance now to win the point. Another opportunity, high and wide for Karakurt, who hammers it down. Volleyball 101 in the end for Turkey. Back to basics, just high and wide, and let the big hitter finish the rally off. Everybody had a go just about, but in the end, it was number 99 who said everybody else's time was up as she finished that rally. That was forced through to the middle. Unfortunately for Annick Meyers, she was chasing after that one, and it fell kindly for Gunesh to get her hands across and into the ball. You could see that Myers is chasing, shoulder was in front of the hips. That's much better. Ball was travelling into where Myers was moving, as opposed to the ball travelling away from where Myers was moving with the last set. Well watched by Uzbek. Oh dear. It was the right choice for Digmus. He spread the play, went behind, and that meant Turkey were chasing out wide to try and make the block. The block wasn't finished, but Myers, for some reason, just didn't get the contact she wanted. Maybe didn't expect to have had that ball come out to her. Swing from Myers, which was picked off by Turkey. They're back now to within a point. Turkish fans are pretty pleased with what they're seeing at the moment. Well, perhaps not so with that serve, but it's another tough one. It was going across the serve receivers, but it was just a little bit too wide of the long line. Good out from Diekman. Jasper, as on the occasion she's been blocked, she's gone in and hit with the same rhythm. Hasn't changed anything, hasn't gone early, swung late, hasn't gone late, swung early. She just goes in and swings the way she's facing, all in the same rhythm, picked up by the blockers. And as a result of that, they're back to within one. Double substitution by Turkey once again. Dilik in to serve. Boj into the front row. Keeping three attacking options at the net. If you have got two good setters and two good opposite players, then the double substitution is well worth doing. That was wild out of play. No wonder Sarioglu was disappointed. Dilik had reached up to play that ball, but it was over the net. It was in Netherlands airspace, and as a backcourt player, she's not allowed to reach across and play the ball. And we head into the technical timeout there. Netherlands leading by three.
It's not possible when they cannot attack, we defend the other court. It's not possible when they attack in the middle of the block, there is nobody. We don't defend one ball. Not one single ball. If they deep, we give again the deep. If they attack in the middle court, we don't defend. Aide, aide, aide!
That was a swing from Balladin. One thing you'll see from Balladin, she's always aggressive on the ball. If it's there to be hit, she hits it. She takes on the block, she takes on what's in front of her. It's so imperative that you have that attacking instinct, that desire to want to win the point. And she's got 14 so far, 9 from spiking, 4 blocks and 1 serving ace. It's something that's been a little bit lacking when we've watched the Netherlands and seen the way that they've attacked the ball. It's almost as if they don't want to, trying not to make an error, as opposed to just being aggressive and saying, right, what's in front of me, what can I do? Again, Dilik, she's a back row player, and the passing unit really are not giving it her any opportunities. Those last two passes have been awful. Into the net, across the centre line. It all went horribly wrong. Ismailoglu's back in. Maybe that will change Turkey's fortunes and strengthen their passing unit. Balladin thinks she's got that off the block and out. They could really do with this point, Turkey, because it's starting to slip away from them this third set. There was indeed a block touch. Four Nicely done. That time it was a faster arm swing before the block can be finished. When you're blocking, you have what's called, ideally the way to describe it, is a now moment. The now moment being when you're pressed across trying to get your hands on the ball, and you want that now moment to be just before the spiker is contacting the ball. That was a good leave. What we invariably see in blocking, especially when we see the slow motions, is the ball has already passed the block and then you're seeing the block finish and get across the net. Whereas ideally they want to be in that position just before the spiker makes contact with the ball. Well, just when it was looking like the Netherlands were going to go on and take this set with the healthy lead, unforced errors have allowed Turkey to catch up. And they're just one behind now. Jasper does well to work Gunesh's hands. Covering by Scoot. Another point for the Netherlands. They may well just hold on in this set. But he's still not happy and has called a timeout.
On a set, because three people call you the ball and you have to set.
He's just not very happy. And
make sure India, you're coming in as a blocking sub right now. Help on the quickly out. Let's go.
Very different style. Jamie Morrison is talking tactics. We need to help on this. We need to do that. Let's get this going. It's all about what they need to do now. He hasn't said anything about the number of balls they've hit out, the number of balls they've hit in the net. He hasn't told them they're not attacking, they're not being aggressive enough. He's just kept it positive and about what we now need to do, what's the next thing we have to do. Much better environment to be in than to have one where you're constantly being criticised and just being reminded of all the things you've done wrong. That was nice. Little combination play, the tandem attack, Gunesh in quick and Izmioglu just over the top. Not worth another look. Opens up that space for her to swing through the middle. As Gunesh takes the middle and opens up the space for Izmioglu to go into. Double substitution has been reversed. And so Karakurt back in. So too, the starting setter, Kansu Uzbay. That was nice. That's a great block from Gunesh because she's one-on-one with an attacker coming through the middle of court, 3 metres back, who's got lots of space left and right to hit the ball. In fact, you can see that Gunesh has reached out to her left to slow, to shut that angle down. That is super blocking from Gunesh.
Get her going here. Hey, nice pass. Nice job. Just so you know, she's diving to your five. If you get it again, you probably have into one. There's a little bit of zone two blocker help, or tip over the top into zone two. Also an option. Let's go.
That's brilliant, isn't it, from Jamie Morrison. He hasn't just said, you've got to attack, you've got to attack. He said, and what he said there was she dived into your five. And what he means by that is she dived into where you were going to hit to position five. And he's saying you've got one is open, which is the other side to position one, or the option of tipping just over the top. Well, it's still in play. Turcotte's now out of the attack. Ismaoglu isn't, but unfortunately for the Netherlands, they've touched the net. And Turkey are now back level. Just that second movement, trying to get across the net instead of going across in one movement. Lushbey now with the serve. It's her third serve in a row. It's been a good run this for Turkey since their double substitution. Ismaoglu's looking for that ball off the block, but she hasn't made it. Oh, she can't believe it. She's, well, in fact, she thinks that it is off the hand, so they've called a challenge. Doesn't look convinced though, does she? There is no touch. It was an error from Ismaoglu. Netherlands have the ball. And Lewis will be serving. Well, they think it's up. Balladin thinks he's got that up. And that is, I believe, a challengeable element. Ball up, ball down. And in fact, that's what they're going to do. So we're going to see whether or not this is a pancake or a cam cake or a... It has been saved. And the other thing we're going to see here is, again, a bit like on the serve where the ball lands and then it impacts on the floor. What we might see is the fact it did catch Balladin, but also some of it caught the floor, in which case it will be down and it will be a point for the Netherlands. And that's where the ball will have compressed down on the hand. Did any of it then catch the floor? See, the hand's definitely under it, and it looks like it has also, though, caught some of the floor as it's done so. So it has gone against Balladin. And that'll be that little bit of compression as it goes down. Turkey then call the timeout. Netherlands two in front.
The ball put down 10 centimeters from your feet. You don't even try. The ball was strong, so of course she's long. We have 12, meet the blocker. We are sleeping in the cold.
There comes a point as a player when you're in an environment like this where the coach behaves like that, where it just becomes white noise and you switch off to it. And it, that helps neither party, because then the coach just becomes more upset when things don't go right. And the players just switch off. But more than anything, it was a timeout just to try and disrupt the Netherlands' rhythm. See whether Turkey can get their side out, get back into it. Oh, it's not going to happen. That's a great block from the Netherlands. And right at the business end of this third set, they extend their lead and put more pressure on Turkey. Swing from Karakurt. Still not over. But the Netherlands know if they can side out next couple of serves, they'll have set point and probably will go on to take the set. It really boils down to just two good side outs for the Netherlands within the next 3 points or so, and the job will be done. Balladin's made the error. And it is now set point for the Netherlands. Hartmer with the serve. Well watched by Karakurt. Ballard in once again. Looking for hands, not finding them. And the Netherlands have taken the third set. 25-21, they're back in this match. Trailing by 1-2. This is how it was done. Served at the front court swing hitter, Ballardin. That was the previous point, which was then the previous element to that point. But look at that. That's gone way out from Ballardin. She missed earlier on. She's missed again. What a turnaround for the Netherlands. They'll be delighted with that. They've got momentum now, potentially, to go on and take the fourth to set up a tiebreaker. That does remain to be seen. What a great set that was. Here are some of the highlights. Here are the stats from that last set. Opponent's errors. The Netherlands got 9 points from Turkey. But it was Turkey who outblocked the Netherlands. Now here are the set of contact points. The majority of them in the area it needed to be, in that green zone where they can then put the ball they want to. And you can see here for Turkey, good serving from the Netherlands, which was drawing the setter off the net. And then making it more difficult to have the options that you would like. Not the best performance from Turkey in the last set. Netherlands played well, hung in there, took the set, kept this match alive, and now we're into set four. The question for the Netherlands is, have they been able to, will they be able to carry through the momentum of that last set now into this to get them to where they want to be, which is into a fifth set where they have to be if they're going to have a chance of taking this match. Take the points any way you can get them. Oh, That one's just drifted wide from Luis. Good view from the end on camera just to see. Well, it was just drifting a little bit too far away from Luis to try to get a hand on it. When you hit the slide behind, ideally you're travelling to your right and the ball is coming along with you. You're kind of moving with it. If it gets past you, then you're in trouble. You're looking to sort of move along with it. And then when you are doing that, it means you can hit the ball at any point along your slide then when you're in the air. And it gives you options to get past the block. That's why it's very effective play in the women's game. To use lateral speed. So what a start this is for Turkey. 4-0 up, Netherlands, or 5-0 up now, Netherlands call the timeout.
Start in our normal spot just because I don't know why, but so many balls are hitting the tape. I don't think we can back up. But make sure we're opening up and make sure we're calling this ball. That last one might have been out. Let's go!
Well, this is a bit of a blow for the Netherlands. After taking the last set, they're getting a good rhythm going. They find themselves 5-0 down. It could be 6. Well, that's a little bit too tight. I'll tell you what, that's a brilliant set from Uzbek. That looked to be going over the net. It looked to have been a horrible pass. Well, it was a horrible pass. But Uzbek has made something out of nothing. Didn't touch the net, kept it on her side, and then Ackman says, brilliant, thank you very much. At last, a point for the Netherlands. It's something to build on now. Really good attitude being shown by Laura Diekma, the captain for the Netherlands. Herself and Scoots, the two oldest players in the team, 29 and 30. The rest of this squad, born in 99 and in 2000 and 2001. It's a very young team here, but Diekma keeping them all together, keeping the smiling going, keeping the positivity going, and helping these guys through a stage in their careers that Diekma knows all too well about, because she was there when she started, and so too was Scoot. The ball in from Ismoglu. Well up from Myers. Unfortunately, though, just not quite enough room for the Netherlands to get a full swing on that one. Ackman doing very well in the block. Karakut's been jump serving well in this match. Although, had to put a little roll on that as the ball was a little bit behind her. Great dig from Scoot. Myers puts it down. Netherlands have the side out. Just about all Ackman could do with it. And she kept it in play. Turkey recycle. Baladin. That's a nice play from her off the block and away. Into the first technical timeout of set 4. Turkey leading by 5.
There, make sure you're back there ready for it if they're going to fire it. So make sure we're there. On 99, I was just talking to Noli. I just want to make sure, where are you, Noli? I just want to make sure you heard me. You went out too early last time. Make sure you see where the set is and then get your feet there. And again, left hand. We just learned that Mirtek can dig the line really well down there. Leave it for her. She has that. Keep pushing from the service line. Let's go.
Nice bits of information from Jamie Morrison. I know that Karakut is a threat, so just saying once you see the ball has been set, you know where it's going to go, and what blockers will do is they're not going to watch the ball all the way. Once they see the beginning of the set, they know the trajectory, they know where it's going, so now they're picking up the hitter, getting out to that position, and then getting across to take away, and in this instance, to take away the power shot from Karakut, wherever it will be, and maybe leaving a little bit of line. But also saying the fact that Turkey have been digging well down the line. That's a great dig. Ekman, though, just rushing that one slightly. Sarioglu made a wonderful dig to get that ball high to the middle of court to allow Uzbe to find Ekman in transition. I'll tell you what, that should go the way of Turkey. And the reason it's not gone the way of Turkey is because Uzbe has been called for a carry. But what else would it be? If she's going to put her hand on the ball and there's a blocker's hand over the top of it, which looked to have touched it instantaneously. Wow, tough one. Referee's made his mind up. And you can't challenge that particular call. Ismailoglu gets that one down. That's a good swing right in between the two Dutch blockers, called the seam. The gap between the blockers is known as the seam. Dikma was a little late getting around that ball, so couldn't generate the power. She wanted to take it all the way out wide. And it was drifting inside, drifting towards where the block was waiting. That's a much better swing. Early and right through the arms, a field goal as that went through the arms of Uzbe. That's up from Timmerman. Nowhere for Mayers to go. Gunesh and Ismailoglu working well. Nice quick play from the Netherlands. If they can up their passing, give Diekmer a ball that she's got options to go middle, out wide, or to the back row. And Turkey are always going to struggle. Any team's going to struggle at this level. Good touch from Myers. Looking for fingers, but the referee says no. Jasper not entirely sure. That doesn't look like they're going to have a challenge. They're going to get on with it. Ismailoglu back to the serving line. Oh. That's really well played. Sometimes you think of the tip and it's just a delicate shot over the block, but that a power tip pushing the ball deep with pace, catching the defence by surprise. Space for Karakirk to work between the two blockers. And then really difficult for the defenders as it caught a piece of the block as it came through. That just completely took it away from Jesper as a result. That's a good wait from Lois. She's up, she can see the ball, she can see the block, waited and then played block out. Continuing the ball on its path and speeding it up slightly. Really good play that from the Netherlands. Lois now to serve. Well worked. Nicole Udi Lutikus the block out. Just a couple of errors creeping in, and the lead is being slowly eroded, which is why Turkey have called timeout.
And she's still receiving the ball in position six right side. And can we make a tip sometime? Because if we score, attack and match on, but because we don't score one eye ball, we can make a tip because in the video of Jan, we saw there all long, and they're still all long. Hide!
Hide!
Here we go!
Hide, hide, hide! You got everything going on over here. Keep going!
Yes!
Let's go!
A serve for the Netherlands. That's a really good way to come in off the back of a timeout and keep the pressure on your opposition. Lois thinks it's in. Turkey, though, are challenging it. It is in. It's a brilliant serve. Once again, lovely set from Uzbe. Slightly quicker ball out wide. The middle had pinned the Netherlands middle, and then there was space for Baladin to work. Unforced error from the Netherlands. That last serve from Karakut. She's actually hit the ball from behind the baseline. Still to perfect her jump serve. The purpose of your jump serve is you want to be throwing that ball into court. You take off from just behind the baseline and then attack the ball from maybe a metre, 2 metres in. And then it's not a serve. It's actually a spike. Again, another one that she serves. She's got plenty of power. Just think how much more power she can deliver and how much more difficult that's going to be if she's hitting that ball 2 metres into court. Still, the rally continues. And it is Baladin who puts it down. And now the Netherlands call timeout. In fact, we're straight into the second technical, so they don't need to call the timeout. An enforced break, slightly fortuitous.
Step in, we're going to pass with four. So that way we'll cut down the seams a little bit. Go ahead and come in on a cue. You'll come in on that. You have a back row option there. Go out to zone four. You got the center out there. So remember, we're attacking off of her if we can. High off the hands. Let's go. Let's go.
Just reminding the players that with Ushbey out blocking, she's the shorter and weaker blocker for Turkey, so the opportunity to go and put the ball over her and attack her is the one that you want to get. And Baladin, well, she's come to the fore in this set. Had a poor end to the last set, but is more than making up for it now, is the outside hitter for Turkey. 19 points so far in the game. That's a good block. Ackman increasing Turkey's lead. Just going back to the serve for Karakurt. Talked about that in a second, but that's another quality block right across the net, closing down the space. Karakurt doesn't have to do anything to change except her starting point. If she starts another meter and a half forward, that means she will be contacting the ball on the serve a metre and a half forward from where she is at the moment, which means she'll be contacting it into court. A double touch given against the Netherlands. It's starting to drift away, isn't it? Netherlands call the timeout. Their time on court is beginning to run out.
Right in the middle of the court, we're going to run our offense here. Again, cue, slide, or sorry, lope, and then a ball out in zone four. Yeah, one center, out. Let's go.
No timeouts left for the Netherlands. They've got a challenge they might be able to use if they needed to try and break things up. And of course they have substitutions as well they can use to disrupt things. Oh, what a brilliant serve that is from Ibra Karakurt. Stopping this youngster. Except the net. Great dig from Diekma. Well watched by Karakurt. Baladin with work to do. Oh, and she's done it. Past two blockers, past Scoot in defence. Turkey take the point. And they're now five away from winning this match. Baladin came in on the cross-court angle. No one shut it down. Good up from Izmioglu. Karakurt full of confidence. And she was moving from inside the court to outside the court. So only really had the block to go after. And she made sure that it paid. You can see as she's travelling that it was the fringes of the block she was looking for. Did look quite close. Turkey think it was in. So back to Hawkeye we go. They've been busy in this match. Close but no cigar. And no point, more importantly, for Turkey. Covering from Ujbay. Good covering from Diekma. Oh, what a shame. Made the touch, but put it in a position where no one could actually go and chase it. Actually meant to do that. Hester Jesper comes in, and off goes Nicole Udelutikus. That's a very nice swing. Timmerman with the serve. Diekma gets in the way. And so too does Gunesh and Ismailoglu to deny Netherlands the point. At last, something for Guidetti to smile about. Working hard in defence, so too Turkey. Lovely from Baladin on the pipe to bring up match point now for Turkey. Uzbay will go back to serve, and what she hopes will be the last point of this match. Free ball for Turkey, three front court attackers. Oh, it's emphatically put away by Gunesh through the middle. Turkey take the set 25-15, and they have beaten the Netherlands by 3 sets to 1.